Alright, so that was fun. I just did some demo with Cross Hatching, and I'm ready to do the curl to curl earring. I do like the brush, but for all intent and purposes, I will be using fine liner. Just like in that fine liner angsty mood, because Vernier is a great painter and I really want to make this look nice. But of course I will draft in pencil. I mean, it's not worth it to spend 15 minutes sitting on my butt recording and messing up halfway through. So this is a great opportunity to see how to really ink. It's always good to start with pencil. So let's begin with the outline. We're going to start with the forehead, eyebrows, eyes, nose, mouth, chin, hair. Should be done in about 10 minutes. So in the first 2 minutes, let's just draft it in shades, block shading, and then we're going to erase. So let's do the forehead. I'm holding it almost like a stick. And we have the top of the head here and the chin here. We have one eye here, and the nose here. And this is the negative space between her neck, and the pearl earring will be about there. So now let's draw in the shapes that we know, such as the top of the head meeting the whatever this is, a bath towel. She lost her other earring in the shower, actually. So it's just the one pearl earring. And now she has to dry her hair. And I always like to start with the eye that is closer. And then I'll see the angle of which the other eye is. So these eyes are not on the same plane, they're just at an angle there. And let's get the exact contours and her cheekbone. Way below here, and that's the left side. She's a very sturdy, slanty nose, which is great for an artist. Very planar. And it's always good to know, like, the nose will point and come out to the indent of her chin and lips, as well as the center of her eye. Like, that's pretty much square. And this part will come in a little bit over here, but her lips will protrude way far out here. you can exaggerate it a little bit for the first part. So, I mean, it does help to have foundation pencil drawing, just because it's so loose. Especially for bigger projects and not sketching or warming up. And this tunic is at a very slight angle. Yep. Now I'm from a bathrobe to a tunic. Tunic is a double version of a eunuch, which is a, you know, what a eunuch is? It's her very fancy. I've never seen actually someone wear this like this. Which is great for drawing because you have all the fabric shades. She looks like she's. I hate when this happens, but whatever. And I need to close her neck a little bit here. Close the neck. Always keep the neck closed. Great. Fantastic. Now I'm just gonna do a quick block of shade here. Just so I don't erase too much. Now I have to erase everything but the contours. Why? Because less and we can really just move forward with speed, and that is the purpose. You do not actually need a perfect drawing, especially with pen. Pen kind of allows us to be bolder, outline it. And I am just sculpting away with my eraser. I'm making it look like we don't even need to use pen. Actually, I won't. This was a whole setup. There's no pen, it's just pencil and eraser. And if you can't do that, well, you have just wasted your time. Just kidding. Here. Okay. So we want to keep the crosshatching similar. And by similar, I mean we want the pen strokes to be the same. Now, the background is black. So, we'll do the background last, but just keep that in mind later. So, I'm going to be doing this one first, or should I do the horizontal? Maybe I should do the horizontal. And I'm just going to do one plane at a time. I do like a 1 inch by 1 inch, which is like this, and I'll do like either 4 or 7. So like for this part, which is nothing, I would barely do anything here. I would just maybe do the edges. For the lips, maybe I'll do a little bit more. Now honest, isn't as fun as I thought it would be, to be perfectly honest. But I am excited to see what it will look like out there. Some of it can be looser. You do want to keep that pen strokes kind of similar. I mean, at least microscopically aligned. Let's start with the eyebrows. She does not have eyebrows, so let's go right to the eyelids. These little dots adds a lot of depth. And then let's work on the nose. I do want to add a lot more value here. Especially for the nostril. And here, I'll add smaller points. So, there's some shade. Maybe I'll include the perpendicular lines. And for here, I will just put one here and that. And I actually will outline the eyes. And I always like to squint like this because you can see where I'm missing light. Okay, so we did the nose, we did the eyes, basically. I will fill in around contour. Now let's do this chin. The real shading begins. I am having doubts about her forehead being that. Like, it definitely comes to only here. And all of this is bogus. Do really good, clean crosshatch here. Thank you. guess it's kind of fun. But now I'm just jumping around places. So maybe I'll use a thicker pencil, pen, brush, thing, nib, chim, and then I'll just block shade this area. Like I said, the background is dark. So that's where your brush comes in. And that's pretty much the basis of this, is having that very dark background against the face. Otherwise, it's just very poor composition. If you just have a face floating. Instead of adding a background, which I could have done as a color. So what are we at for time? Probably like 15 minutes. We got everything done. We're just working on the background. And everyone's probably like freaking out with their dimensions and all that, but it's really just about consistency, using your best judgment to fill composition, and start with the eyebrows and the eyes and the nose and the mouth, and then the rest you can kind of work in as details. And we do need to get that earring in there somewhere, right? And I definitely want to smooth the outline out. Let's give her a glow for the eye, which is basically very dark contrast with a light. She has soft eyes. See, then what happens is my eye will just look at this part and I'll spend like way too much time on there. Or I could clearly do this like 3 times and 2 out of 3 it would be 20 times better than the first one. Get that earring in here somewhere. Probably like right here. Now let's make sure the neck is visible. Whatever. Well,